We started with a bare 55-gallon tank with the background painted black. The stand is an inexpensive pine stand, also painted black. We would use two pieces of driftwood as the key features of the aquascape. They would divide the tank into thirds. Before final placement of the driftwood, however, we would install a substrate heating system, popular in Europe. This one is made by Tunze. All right, I tell you what, I measured this out, and there's about 30 feet of this white cable here, which means I've got to go back and forth a lot inside my 4-foot tank here to use it all up. And one of the things that Tunze gives you in order to make you be able to do that are these suction cups that I just showed you. So I'm going to string a bunch of these on there, and we'll just keep going, and then as I place this in the tank, we'll be able to use the suction cups to keep it in place underneath the substrate. Once we get done, we'll take the cables and we'll put those in either end of the transformer, which we'll store right down here.
Substrate heaters keep the gravel just a bit warmer than the surrounding water, which stimulates the roots and, in theory, causes the water to circulate continuously to the roots, bringing additional nutrients and preventing decay of the bottom material. On top of the heater coils, we added a 5-gallon bucket of substrate from aquariumplants.com. Following the directions on the label, we rinsed only once. This would provide enough substrate for a 3-inch average. However, we piled it more deeply in the back, sloping toward the front. Next, it was time to prepare the plants. Each plant was carefully removed from the basket in which it arrived. The floss was gently removed from the roots. Damaged leaves were trimmed away so the plant would not devote energy trying to repair the old growth. We wanted new growth. Many plants can and should be separated into multiple smaller plants before you put them in the tank. Later, they'll grow toward one another and create beautiful sections. Roots of most of the plants were trimmed to be just long enough to anchor the plants in the substrate. Once our plants were ready, we placed them in the tank, starting with the tallest in the back. Two arrowhead plants filled the left rear corner. A number of Cryptocoryne wentii, Amazon swords, red melon swords, and a lone cypress made up the rest of the background. The plan for the middle of the tank was low-growing plants, clusters of Undulata and Lutea, along with some Anubias, which would be placed in front of the various pieces of driftwood. We also separated two bunches of Microsword and tried to establish a nice low-growing area next to one piece of driftwood. We'll see how that works out. Once the tank was planted, we added tap water, seeded the biological filter with Special Blend from Microbe Lift and Safe Start from Tetra, and we waited for things to clear. Lighting is provided by a current Nova Extreme fixture with 4 high-output T5 bulbs rated at about 6,700 degrees. Over the next 2 weeks, we added some cardinal, rummy nose, and gold pristilla tetras. Now it was time to fertilize. We wanted to use a pelleted fertilizer, which would be placed with tweezers underneath the roots of each individual plant, at least the larger ones. We placed them occasionally among the smaller plants. The hope is that fertilizing the roots directly will reduce the amount of algae in the tank while still stimulating the plants. After about 3 weeks, the tank is thriving and enjoyable to watch. Coming up in part 2 of the series, we'll take a look at what actually worked here, we'll look at some of the mistakes we made, and there were several, and we'll evaluate the plant growth. Again, the essential question is how far can you take a planted tank, at least this planted tank, without CO2 injection? Thanks for watching.